broadcast network, AfterBuzz TV. Over 20 million weekly downloads in over 150 countries and your number one source for after-show entertainment. Very good, Dean TV, the destination for TV superfans, producing aftershows for over 300 of your favorite TV shows, interviewing celebrities and showrunners, and bringing you behind-the-scenes exclusives. All thanks to E! Entertainment's Maria Menounos, producer Kevin Undergaro, and internet leader Akamai. Now, let the buzz begin!
Hello, Happyland fans. Welcome to the very first Happyland AfterBuzz After Show. We're happy.
Don't mind me. I'm just singing along.
I'm your host, Yael Tygiel. Singing along, we have Kylie Hodges.
Hi.
She's also in the chat role, I believe, on the site.
Yeah, I'm trying. I'm apparently internet inept.
I believe
but
it.
But I'm working on it. If you see my name, Kylie Hodges, chat with me. I'm right here.
Yeah, so chat with her. Also, you can tweet at us. We're recapping the pilot episode of Happyland, which I gotta say, I was excited about the show. I heard it was a soapy teen dramedy, and I expected it to be an hour-long show, and it was not, which there are only 8 episodes this season.
What? For real?
Of a 30-minute show, do you know how much information they're going to pack into 4 hours?
Yeah. Faking it on MTV is the same way. There was 8 episodes last season, and it was only a half hour, so it was like, wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. So yeah. Much in 30 minutes, you know?
Yeah.
It's really more like 22.
Right. This season's going to be awesome. This episode just flowed so much. They were like, here's what we're setting up. Here's what's happening. Here's a reveal. Mm-hmm. I'm like, what? How did we do this in 30 minutes?
Yeah, it was crazy.
It was great. Let's jump into Happyland.
Yeah.
Which is a theme park with Ricky Raccoon.
I feel like it greatly resembled somewhere in Southern California.
Oh, yeah? Where?
It sounds like Schmizneyland.
Schmizneyland.
Bombed that one.
Yeah, good job. I believe it does resemble Schmizneyland.
Yeah,
we
totally
do have the characters and the princesses. We've got, I just want to understand, I really hope they explain the story of this land.
Yeah. Because
there's Ricky Raccoon, who's kind of a cowboy.
Mm-hmm.
We have Princess Adriana.
And Prince Valor.
And Prince Valor, which I just want to know what the plot is of that.
Yeah, where does the raccoon play into this love story between Prince Valor and Princess
A cowboy Adria? Raccoon. He's not just a raccoon, he's a cowboy.
I mean, there are no barriers in the cartoon world, really.
Right.
I wouldn't discriminate on an animal trying to be a cowboy.
No, I'm just saying, I don't understand where he falls into Princess Adriana's world.
A former flame before Prince Valor came into the mix.
Maybe he's the, like, fun sidekick. He's the, like, Mushu from Mulan.
Or the bad boy that keeps trying to steal her.
The raccoon.
Yeah.
Okay. You have a crazy...
I'm a dreamer.
Yeah. So we meet the people who run Happyland.
Mm-hmm.
We have Lucy, who is the diligent, creative...
She's kind of like a showrunner. Yeah, stage manager, assistant director, all that jazz.
She's like very good at her job, which impresses me because of her upbringing, because we also meet her mother, Elena.
Disaster.
Who's 17 years older than her.
But looks 5 years older than her, in my opinion.
Not even.
Yeah, they're twins.
Basically. I mean, she is a good, like, half a head taller. That's how you know she's the mom.
Mm-hmm.
That's how it is, guys. That's
I'm taller. I'm the mom.
Yeah.
And this so is... I'm your mother.
Yep, exactly. I believe it.
Yeah, me too.
We also meet Ian and his abs. Yeah, you want to take a deep breath there.
I needed to spray myself down with some cool water after that scene. I think they sprayed his abs down, too, purposely just to get me a little
They were
hot
glistening.
And bothered.
They were glistening. We have Harper, who is Lucy's friend.
Yeah.
I don't want to say best friend because Harper's boyfriend, Will, is supposed to be Lucy's best friend. Will and Harper are together.
Mm-hmm.
Harper's parents just moved to corporate, which means they move from the little town that everyone lives in to a nicer town called Dazzle.
Yeah, which I have a question. Is the town named Happyland in addition to the park that they work in?
No. I would think that it's, this is my theory, I don't know this for sure. I would think it's like the neighborhood where it is. So like, for example, for those who know, Universal Studios is in like Universal City.
Yeah.
Even though that's not really a place.
Sure it is.
Yeah. So I think it's like Dazzle is this community within the vicinity or the land owned by Happyland.
Yeah.
That's what I think. It's my theory, at least.
That's a good theory.
I've never heard of a theme park that, like, requires the employees to live there. Right?
No. Sounds a little... kind of sounds like the projects. Doesn't it?
I mean, that's where Lucy...
no one seems...
That's where Lucy lives.
Yeah. She's complained about not being highest on the economic totem pole.
Right. but Harper has moved from...
And that's because she's with Will, her boyfriend, right?
No, she moves because her parents got a job in corporate.
Ah.
And Will still lives in the other area, which I was told is called the Brick.
Which that totally sounds like it's a ghetto, right?
Right. Like, I'm sorry, Happyland overlords. Like, naming one area Dazzle and one area the Brick. Like, yeah.
Stay away from those parts.
Class war. And we also get to meet Theo, who is checking. He's snooping around. He's in a suit. He's so good looking. And he is Ian's older brother, as we discover.
Yes.
And they are both, as we discover, we'll get to it, that we discover that they are both Chandlers.
Oh, I thought you were going to say both handsome.
Oh.
Very accurate. Yeah. Very accurate.
They were beautiful. Oh, yeah. And we have Dirty Dave.
Played by Josh Groban. Oh my God. I didn't know Josh Groban was in this show.
Nobody knew.
And I lost my shit when I saw him. He's so funny.
He's perfect. Amazing. Yeah. I saw him and I was like, that's funny. That guy looks like Josh Groban.
Yeah.
And then you see him again. And I was like, oh my God, what is he doing
that's
there?
That's what I did. When I saw him, I was like,
when he's peeing.
Twins? Yeah. And then I picked up my computer and I was like, that is Josh Groban. I had to get really close.
I was like, I was watching it on a giant screen. And I still was like,
you must live in Dazzle.
I do live in Dazzle. No, I stole a TV from Dazzle and put it in the Brick. So we start the episode seeing Lucy running around doing her job well. We have a new Ricky Raccoon played by Ian who is high as a kite and passes out while performing.
Which, that doesn't make sense to me. By the end of the episode, it just seems very... It kind of seems uncharacteristic of him. Like, it made me feel like he was just doing that to mess with all the other employees and see how they handle it.
Why?
I don't know, because he seems a little more... He seems way more put together than in the initial, I'm high, I'm gonna do a Ricky tumble.
I think it's that he doesn't want to be there. I think he really doesn't want to be there. And so he got high because he was like, well, if I have to be here, I'm going to deal with it by being high. Mm. Then he gets promoted to a cooler job and meets Lucy and gets to start having feelings for her. And so then he, like, switches to being a better guy.
Gotcha.
That's my theory on his behavior.
That makes sense.
I'm with it. There's character growth in one episode that was 22 minutes.
I know. It's awesome, right?
Amazing. The season's going to be so good.
Yeah.
So Lucy comes home after the night of this craziness, and her mom is there with Chef Avinash, who is a chef from a Happyland elsewhere. And she's like, this is my daughter, or my sister.
My sister.
She's like, yeah, a sister that came out of her 17 years ago. Did anyone else catch what that means? She said, I'm the sister that she gave birth to.
I mean...
It means
she was joking.
Yeah, but if you listen to that sentence, it means that they're sisters and she's her daughter.
Yeah, I know. Right?
Like,
because she was implying
that her father...
that's her mom.
Right, but the sentence that she's saying is that her father is also her mom's father.
Oh, gross.
Yeah, like the second time I heard it, I went, that I don't think is what they meant to go for.
Really gross.
Disgusting. This is an SVU, guys. So we see that Lucy is really the mom in the family. The bills aren't paid. The pills aren't paid.
Neither are the bills.
Yeah. and there are no groceries for dinner. But we hear that tomorrow is the summer happy ball. And so there's going to be free food. So we don't have to eat today. We'll eat tomorrow.
I was very judgy of Elena.
Yes.
Lucy's mom.
Shock.
Get it together, Elena.
Yeah.
That's all I got.
Oh. Because she's a kid.
Yeah. This isn't like some Cinderella business where she's supposed to be taking care of you.
Well, we see that, like, she when Chef Avinash runs out, that she says, like, this, he could have been the love of my life.
Mm-hmm.
She's literally looking for who she believes is going to be the love of her life, which is the weirdest, I think. I mean, at that point, shouldn't you give up? I'm such a cynic. That was terrible.
No, Yael, you shouldn't give up.
No?
No! She's probably 30 anyway. Or she looks like it. No, I mean, she's probably like almost 40, pushing 40. You shouldn't give up. That's, you're only halfway there.
I meant her.
The other half of the marathon. She should give up. Well, she's a disaster of a person, yeah. So maybe she should focus on feeding her child.
What? But feeding and paying the bills?
If she fell in love, if the love of her life was conveniently a wealthy chef.
But there he's you not go. A wealthy chef. He's a chef at Happyland.
You never know what they're paying. Those Chandler boys are dressed well.
I'm sorry. Have you been to a theme park and seen the kind of food they have there that a chef would make?
I actually enjoy some of the food at Disneyland. Don't get me started
at Schmizneyland.
Schmizneyland. Yeah. It's copyrighted.
What kind of food do you enjoy at Disneyland?
Their clam chowder and the bread bowls is the bomb diggity. Ugh. Just saying.
First off, that's California Adventures, but okay.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
And if you want that, it's from Northern California.
Also, I'm pretty sure Club 33, which is like the most exclusive restaurant in all of Disney, probably has good food because it's like 4 money signs on Yelp. Which means I can't afford to go there. So it's got to be primo.
It has to be good. Well, Lucy is not having this Happyland thing.
Nope.
She wants to spend her summer curing diseases. No, giving cures to people.
Like a mini Peace Corps.
Yeah, called Relief Partners. Mm-hmm. She goes to the interview and it goes terribly. So she waits and stalks Denise outside to try to explain her, like, why she wants to do it. And instead, just quotes the mission statement. Clever. Real clever.
Yeah, you would think with all the time she spent waiting outside of that building, she could have thought of something better to say.
Right. I agree. Luckily, Denise is like, hey, just tell me why you want to do it. That's what I'm looking for. And she explains that she lives at Happyland, and their motto is that dreams come true, and that, you know, life is a fairy tale, but she wants to be part of something real. And that tugs, I think, at Denise's heartstrings and says, come for a final interview. Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Drama ensues.
Right? Before we get to the drama, guys, I want to take a moment to thank you for listening and streaming and downloading and watching. We appreciate it. We like this show. Mm-hmm. I don't know if we've mentioned it. We do like this show, and we come here to talk about it for you and with you. So all we ask is something very simple. If you like our show, go onto iTunes, rate and review us. Give us a 5-star if you like us, a 4-star if you don't. That's okay. We understand. Just leave a comment letting us know what we can be doing better, which of the boys you want to see shirtless some more, or so far we haven't seen them. Just leave us comments and let us know.
Yeah.
That's all we want. So we have the summer happy ball where Elena sees Ian and Lucy is like, I don't like him.
Mm-hmm.
And she says he's a huge dick.
And her perverted mother,
I love it,
thinks she hears something else.
Well, yeah, because, I mean, maybe he does.
Yeah. You know what, though? The minute that Elena said to Lucy, stay away from boys like Ian,
mm-hmm.
instantly I was like, she hooked up with the owner of
James.
Happyland. I didn't even know that James was Ian's dad yet. I was just like, oh, she's obviously back in her day been around the block with the head honchos at Happyland before.
Oh.
Like, I knew. Did you catch on?
Well, I knew because of the trailers before the episode. I knew what was going to happen.
Oh, fine.
So,
you spoiled it for yourself. They spoiled it for us.
Yeah, that was the big twist at the end was in the trailers. Which I think is...
Good thing I didn't watch them.
Yeah, I think it was a really heartbreaking...
Yeah, because I was actually delightfully shocked.
Yeah.
Like, when I found out the twist, I was like, woo, yeah, gotta be a great show.
See, you're weird.
Thank you.
You should watch some SVU.
No, that stuff keeps me up at night. That would haunt me.
And this doesn't? Falling in love with your brother?
I mean, there are worse problems. You know, there's Ebola. There's Ebola in this world now. That's what also keeps me up at night, not incest.
Anyways, we meet the Chandler family.
Sorry, took a dark turn.
Yeah, we meet James, who is now returning to be president of the company. His son, Theo, who is going to be creative director. And his youngest son, who's going to work his way up the ranks and has already gone from a furry to a face, which is, I guess, an upgrade.
Yeah.
For those who don't know, at Schmizneyland, your ranking in characters is by height.
What?
It's by height.
What do you mean?
I have a friend who went in, and by height, they assign you who you're going to be. Unless it's like a princess, which is by height and appearance. But like all the princesses are around the same height.
So if you're short and you're not a princess, you'll never be... I'm confused. What do you mean? So they only like, pick who you are depending on how tall you are?
Yeah. So I'm the height of a chipmunk.
Oh, wow. I wonder what I could be. How tall
goofy.
Are you?
I'm very short. You'd be Goofy or the other one.
Pluto?
That's... Nope. Nope, I'm thinking of someone else. I don't know.
I mean, I'm 5'10". I would have to be a big...
You'd be a tall one.
Wow.
Yeah, that's how they do it at Schmizneyland.
That's fascinating. I didn't know that.
Yeah. So this whole going from being in the costume to being a face, I don't believe that that's how it works there.
Well, it is Happyland.
It isn't Schmizneyland.
Yeah, that's right.
I love that we're calling it that.
Schmizneyland.
So then we see this really awkward interaction with Elena and James and Theo. Where James is like, oh, I think I remember you. Smooth. And then Theo is like, it's great to meet people who've been around for a long time.
Theo's a tool.
Well, so what James said in his speech was that that Happyland was opened 20 years ago by his father, Hank, I believe. And she, Elena's been a princess there for 15 years.
Mm-hmm.
So that means that 2 years after she started there, she had Lucy.
Relations within the company.
No. Uh-oh. No.
Well, yeah.
If she's been doing it for 15 years, isn't she 17?
Oh, you're right.
So 2 years
before. So she would have been before she started working there. Well.
Maybe it was before she was a princess. Maybe she was something else first.
Yeah, maybe she was what Lucy's doing now.
And then she got upgraded to princess after she... James.
That could be it.
Got it. Okay. And then we see this amazing view of the park, and all I could think was, did they just take like parts of Schmizneyland and parts of like other places and like green screen them on?
Six Flags.
Yeah.
Four Flags. I'll call it Four Flags.
Four Flags.
Copyright.
The Flags and Schmizneyland. I feel like they took like, here's a roller coaster and like, photoshopped it onto other, like that's what I imagined happened to make a happy land. And we see that Harper kind of has this crush on Ian.
Mm-hmm. Which, what does Harper do? Does she work at the park?
Yes. What at the park does she do?
We don't know.
We don't know.
Okay.
But she says she works at the park and her parents moved to corporate.
Mm-hmm.
We know that Will was a Ricky. But in a different costume, not the cowboy one.
Oh.
It looked like a Hawaiian shirt. Maybe he wasn't a Ricky. Maybe he was someone else. Anyway, all sorts of craziness.
Yeah, it's. I did notice that this show definitely threw a lot of people at us very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I feel like we didn't even know Lucy's name until at least 5 minutes in. Because I don't think we hear her name until her mom says, this is my sister, Lucy.
Mm.
I think. I rewatched that part because I was like, oh, is that when they say her name? But could have been said earlier on and I missed it.
Yeah. I mean, I agree. I think there's a lot thrown at us.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't find out a lot of stuff until later.
Mm-hmm.
And so we see in the morning after the happy ball that, you know, Lucy kind of has a fight with her mom.
Wait, let's back up for a second.
Yeah.
So, at the happy ball,
mm-hmm.
Ian goes up to Lucy.
Yeah.
And he's kind of chatting her up. And he takes Harper and her up on top of some sort of building.
Yeah, to see the beautiful view.
Yeah, but that was, he was definitely given, I feel like he was given Lucy the eyes.
Yeah.
But then Harper was all like, do you think he likes me?
Yeah, I agree. Drunk girl. I think Ian, as soon as he saw her and she saw his abs, I think that was the moment.
Love at first sight of abs.
Yeah, did you see those abs?
I mean, I was in love at first sight of his abs as well.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm going to just say it because it's going to start with this episode and we'll just move on from the rest of the season. Papa James, what a DILF. I just want it noted.
They are all good looking men in that family.
They are so good looking in that family.
Hashtag abs. I'm just, every time I tweet about Happyland and the character Ian played by Shane
Harper,
I'm just going to end it with hashtag abs. That's the only quality I really am paying attention to.
He has a face?
He has a great face, but I really like those abs. Anyways, continue.
Wait, no, now I'm distracted. I'm thinking
by
about
abs?
His abs. Yeah.
So you said
James is a
DILF.
Oh, we're talking about James
is
a DILF. Yeah, James is a DILF. Yeah.
And Elena probably thought the same thing.
Oh, yeah. Because she ILFed. Anyway.
They did it.
Lucy has a fight with her mom in the morning and says some really hurtful things that are true.
Yeah, totally. I mean, Elena sucks. She's a crappy mom.
Whoa. I feel so bad for Camille.
Well,
sorry, Camille.
She has all season to redeem herself. Camille, yeah. Camille's the name of the actress who plays
Camille Guadi, yeah.
So, I mean, come on. 17-year-old Lucy comes home from working late. Her mom was on a date, and yet the refrigerator has, what'd she say, peanut butter and batteries in
it? Yes, delicious.
Get it together.
And the bills haven't been paid yet.
Right. And then why is it that the 17-year-old daughter has to say, oh, I'll spot you on the bills this month?
Also,
what is Elena doing with all of her money?
She is buying wine for dates.
Well, it makes me wonder if Lucy makes more than Elena. Don't you think Lucy's position would make more than a character?
Oh, for sure. I definitely believe that.
Interesting.
That being said, I think they're both making minimum wage.
Totally.
Which I believe California has the highest minimum wage, and they are not in California.
Oh. It's so, said that they're not in California?
I believe the car license plate was Arizona.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
Yeah. So after having a fight with her mother, Lucy goes to see Harper and has a fight with her over Will.
Mm-hmm.
I was really hoping that Harper's belief that Will was in love with Lucy was an overreaction. I really was hoping that. Unfortunately, from the previews for the rest of the season, I don't think that's necessarily true. And that bums me out.
Mm. Why does that bum you out?
Because I like it when you have two characters, a male and a female character, and they're just friends and there's no sexual attraction.
Ah,
or romantic attraction. That being said, it's a
soapy
team.
Like How I Met Your Mother minus Robin.
Yes.
Okay.
That being said, it's a soapy teen dramedy, and I knew that eventually it would happen.
Yeah, totally. Any of these shows.
Yeah, everyone's going to hook up with everybody.
Every TV show, rom-com situation, there's never just guy and girlfriends. They all weave. Even if it's for just one episode, they all have their moment together.
Sad.
I mean, spices things up, you know?
Yeah, whatever. Well, Lucy goes to work after offending Harper in a way that is kind of true. I mean, both times that she was in fight, that she was said something rude, she was right.
Yeah.
Both times.
Because Lucy is, like, the most responsible person on this show so far.
I'm like this.
Vast generalizations.
I mean, if you compare, I'm going to quickly compare this to Finding Carter, which is another MTV show that we cover together.
Mm-hmm.
And that main character of Carter is the least responsible person. Mm. I think I really like having this contrast.
Yeah.
I like it.
I like where you're going with this.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So Lucy goes to work and she has an hour till she has her second meeting, the final meeting with the relief partners people. Unfortunately, her mother hasn't shown up for work.
Oh, that made me so mad. It's
for
like
the first time in 15
call.
Years. Yeah. Nobody has phones.
Text messages.
Yeah. First time in 15 years, she misses a day. And, of course, Theo is there to be very disapproving.
He looks like the Secret Service standing in the hallway in a suit. It's like, who is this guy just yelling at everybody?
I just want everyone to know that Ryan Rottman has beautiful eyes.
Oh, Talk about how you met the cast.
We will.
Oh, sorry. I'm so anxious.
Get excited.
Continue recapping.
He has beautiful eyes. That's important.
I believe that.
They were so beautiful. So Lucy has to step in as a princess, Princess Adriana. Mm-hmm. That really bothers me that it's Princess Adriana and Prince Valor.
Why?
Because Prince Valor is like his name is his quality, whereas hers is a name.
Do you want her to be Princess Beautiful?
I want her to be Princess
Honesty.
Yeah,
grace,
something like that.
Humility.
Yes. Yes. Princess Honor. That'd be nice.
That is kind of nice. Princess Really Good at Math. That would be nice. A little change of pace from only rewarding women for their looks.
I said honor.
I know. I'm just spicing things up.
Yeah. And she's really bad at math. Anyway.
Obviously, we shouldn't be running a theme park or writing stories about princesses.
That's true.
Yeah.
Princess Honor was a feminist. That's how our story would start. All right, so she's got 1 hour. She's filling in for her mom, and she fills in with Ian. Dun, dun, dun.
Ooh, sparks were flying.
Yeah, they were. It was really cute and romantic. Yeah, and then Ian drives her to her thing. What a sweetheart.
And he's like, speeding.
And she's changing
in the backseat. And she tells him to look, and then what does he do? He looks.
Yeah, of course he looks.
Because he's naked into girl in the her.
Back. Also, there's a naked girl in the back.
Also, I would like to point out that...
Yes?
Uh-oh. The actress's name who plays Lucy.
Bianca.
Looks a lot like Vanessa Hudgens.
Okay. Yes, she does.
Is Vanessa Hudgens Latina?
I believe so.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to say this, though. I think Bianca prettier than Vanessa. I'm going to say it. Fans don't hate me.
I mean, I'm like, indifferent to Vanessa Hudgens, but I, you know, I like the show. So I'll just be like, yeah, I love Bianca. I did like Spring Breakers, though. Good movie.
Yeah.
Anyways, I digress. Go on.
So they get to the interview, and she misses it.
By a half hour. Okay.
Yeah.
If you were Lucy.
Mm-hmm. If I were Lucy, me?
Yeah.
Okay, let me tell you what I would do.
Okay, because then I'll tell you what I would do.
I would have called to let them know that I had a family emergency, I was running late, and I would be there.
Mm-hmm.
Like a responsible adult.
That's what I was going to say.
Yeah.
And I think nobody in this show knows how to use a cell phone properly.
I assume no one there has a smartphone either at this point.
Or, if anything, I would have been kind of a jerk and done the show in half the time.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, the song's pre-recorded. I would have meet and greeted for half the time.
Yeah.
Ridiculous.
Just done a express performance. Sorry, kids.
Yeah.
My life is more important outside of your $800 you spent to be here.
Oh, Schmizneyland.
That's depressing. Schmizneyland is expensive.
So she misses the interview. Denise is not having any of it, which I understand because... If I were Denise and I saw this person come in and tell me that they wanted to do this, I would be so disappointed in them. They, like, clearly suck at what they want to do.
Yeah.
Like, she doesn't show any responsibility, any initiative, any qualities that you want in someone who's going to join the relief partners.
Yeah, you need, like, a go-getter.
Mm-hmm.
And don't get me started on her interviewing skills.
Yeah.
She just kept going, I'm bad at math. Wait, I wrote it down. I'm bad at math and jokes. That's what she said.
Yeah.
I mean, I get it. She's only 17, but...
What, how did she get... I just wonder how she got... Like, because she, as we saw in the beginning of the episode, she was qualified enough to make it up to the kind of managerial position she has.
She came across very unprepared. And you're right. For being what would be like a finalist, you would think she would be a little more intuitive with... how to speak with an adult.
But also, her responsibilities that she has at Happyland make it seem like she's capable of holding a job.
Yeah.
And she's responsible enough to pay bills.
And she's very well-spoken when on the job, so it was weird how poorly she spoke at the interview.
Yeah. I mean, I'm sure she was nervous.
Yeah.
That's no excuse.
No. We're cracking the whip on you, Lucy.
Well,
we're
she's
harsh.
Bummed. She comes out and she tells Ian, we got to get back to Happyland.
Mm-hmm.
Can't
she
take
didn't
costumes
get it.
Out of the park.
They said they found somebody else for the position already.
In
interesting.
That half hour?
Yeah.
That's
what I thought.
That's a line. That's a, we're not giving it to you. We don't know how to say that nicely.
Well, who knows what'll happen.
Yeah. And as they arrive back at Happyland, Ian kisses her. Thanks for that.
I loved that. I was jealous of Lucy.
I loved that her mom yelled, stop!
Yeah. You're going to get pregnant and die, as said in Mean Girls.
Yes. Sorry. I just don't understand why she walk over to them. She, like, stayed. She stayed away and yelled, stop!
Their lips have already touched. They're already attracted to each other. By stopping a kiss is not going to immediately stop them from liking each other. In fact, it's just going to piss them both off quite a bit. Yeah.
Ridiculous.
A very dramatic scene. I loved it.
Followed by an even more dramatic scene.
Oh, God. I loved this so much. Go for it. Say it.
Elena explains why she missed work, because she got a call from James. I'm sorry. He's your boss, and he calls you during work hours and doesn't let anyone know that you're not going to make it to your shift?
Like, yeah.
Who runs Happyland that there's no communication that this employee is being spoken to with the supervisor? You know what I mean?
Another tie with Finding Carter. The adults are children and the children are adults.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, now keep going with the story because I have things to say.
Okay. So Elena was missing work because she was talking with James. James Chandler, who is Ian's father. Yeah, I know he's Ian's father.
Yep.
And your father.
Hey-o! Drama ensues! Now,
yeah.
Why is the dad calling the mother and telling her that he's the father? Shouldn't she know that?
I don't think
he should be more unaware than she is.
I don't think he called to say that he is her father.
Oh, then what do you think he called about?
I think he called to talk to her because he's back in town.
Ah, okay, because the way it was delivered, I was like, how is she just now knowing that James is the father? Between the two, she should know
she's
before.
She's just telling Lucy.
Because she knows she can't keep the secret any longer.
Especially because she doesn't want Lucy kissing Ian. She's trying to let her know.
Okay, I didn't think this question through before I answered it, but now that I'm realizing it, I should have put the context clues together and figured out that scene a little better.
Did you watch the show?
Yes, absolutely. I'm talking out of emotion right now. I'm just very, because I just watched it. I'm very worked up right now.
Yeah.
I'm excited.
It was great. It was a great twist. It was something that the fans knew was coming, but still was exciting to see.
Yeah. That was so good.
It was great. I think it's time for news and gossip.
Ooh.
Yeah.
TV news.
As Kylie said, Sam, who is our third co-host who couldn't make it tonight, Sam Danson.
The ghost of Sam.
She and I got to chat with the cast of Happyland at a makeshift Happyland at the Santa Monica Pier. Go and check those interviews out. They're on YouTube. I will tweet those out. I will make sure Kylie retweets them.
I will.
Yeah. We got to talk to everyone. We got Bianca, Camille, Shane, Katherine McNamara, who plays Harper, and Ryan Rottman, who plays Theo.
Mm.
Check those out. His eyes are beautiful. Amazing, amazing interviews. Very fun. Very cool people. We get a little bit of, information about the show and what we can look forward to. I think it was really exciting. I wish I would have known that Josh Groban was in it.
Oh, my God. Was he there?
No. That would have been that would have been amazing.
All right.
Yeah.
Guys, we are going to make it our goal to get as many people from the show in here in studio with us throughout the season because that's too good of a show and we love these characters too much. And I am just going to die and go to heaven.
And keep your hands to yourself.
Yeah, you're going to have to put me in like a...
Straight jacket
if Ian, what's his face, comes in.
Ian Harper.
Shane Harper.
Shane Harper, who plays Ian. My bad.
Oof, they're handsome.
They are handsome. The ladies are also gorgeous. Beautiful. Oh, my goodness. And you know what? I'm going to do this. I want the fans to comment on iTunes who they want to see in the studio with us.
Yeah, there you go.
And we will get who you guys want.
The most requested person is who will work towards getting in here.
Yeah.
Nice.
So get on that, fans. On that note, I think it's time for predictions.
Oh.
Ooh, flashy
now,
lights.
You're after Buzz TV.
Predictions.
So, according to this season on Happyland, here's what we can look forward to in the next 7 episodes.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my goodness. I just can't believe it's 4 hours. That's it this season. Ian wants Lucy. Yeah. They're prince and princess together. She's going to become a full-time Adriana.
Yeah.
That's intimidating.
So I want to know what happens to Mom. Elena.
Yeah, I'm sure she's furious. It seems that Elena and James are getting close, but Lucy is not allowed to have a relationship with him. What?
Yeah.
I feel like that's going to be in the next episode or two.
It's like she's like the bastard child or something.
Yeah. We've got a dead man in the park who's happy sleeping. Will, turns out Harper was right. Will wants Lucy. Shock. And
everybody wants Lucy.
Yeah. And there's some redheaded guy, I think, that starts dating around. And there's... is he Harper's brother? Is he someone else? Who knows? So that's what we have for this season on Happyland. On that note, Kylie, make some predictions.
I'm going to have to predict that... I think there's going to be, like, some real love triangles going on. It's going to be, like, dudes duking it out for Lucy.
Awesome.
You go.
I think it's going to be more than a triangle. I think we're going to have octagons. That's what I think.
Yeah. It's going to be a lot of tangling.
Yeah. We're bad at math, but we know our shapes.
Incestual park love.
Gross.
Yeah. Oh. They are related.
Awesome. All right, Kylie. Thank you so much for joining us. Tell the people where they can find you online.
Find me on Twitter and Instagram. We love chatting with you guys. You can follow me at the Kylie Hodges.
Awesome. And of course, you can find me online at yell.tv. That's Yael.tv. There you'll find information about the beautiful stylings from Siren's Boudoir. You can also find me on Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and Google+. At Yael Tygiel. That's Yael Tygiel. Make sure you're following us on Twitter to see the interviews. And we'll see you next week.
Bye!
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.